So if you tell immortal something, classics he studies, he will not understand. He or she will not understand. Suppose you try to teach a class 2 student maths of class 6, he will be doing for it. Similarly, what he will be doing and enjoying, he will be why still doing the childish things. So society is from nursery onwards, and the person who has just come into school has come from where? He has come from the animal kingdom. They have just come from the animal kingdom, so what does he know? He knows the animal instincts of fight and flight. So the people which we label as murderers, rapists, thieves, robbers, and put them in prison, they are the ones who have just come from these. They only know that, they don't know anything more. They are being put them up. With time, they are children, they start getting love. And love comes in. Then they start sharing. Then the neighbors. So as they learn lessons, they keep going. Similarly, if you are in class 6, 7 and a child is in class 12, and you tell him, you must save for a hard day, you should not spend your money and give it up. He says, what will I do with the money? Let me donate that person to the building. So how is this person? You keep telling him, he doesn't understand. He's already learned that all this is not of much use. He is already in class 12. Eventually, when you have learned all the lessons, you won't be able to come back to earth. So that is what we call nirvana or moksha, or freedom from the cycle of birth. And then those people remain in the realm of souls as the masters. So they don't come down, but they come right to the beach. And they live there as in another realm, which is the realm of the higher souls. So this is a progression which you have to go through. Now, if we talk a little bit about the strife which is there, the anxiety and the stress which everybody feels every day. Most of these are because of two reasons. It is your expectations and your desires. We have expectations, we have desires. Everybody has. The problem is, society has become in such a way that we start expecting from everywhere, from everybody, and even from ourselves. And all your expectations are never fully fulfilled. Out of 10, maybe 9 are fulfilled, 1 is not. So if 1 is not fulfilled, what happens? You are irritated. Something you wanted very badly. You are frustrated. You are helpless. You can't help them. You are depressed. Again, the cycle of negative energy which is expressed eventually arises. So what should you do? What can you do? You have to cut down expectation and desires, and instead have targets and goals. Now, this is in essence what happens to the soul, the normal, what happens to it. But there are some more final aspects to it. A person dies. Soul is released. Now as we have talked, the soul will go to the other side. But how will you know how to go to the other side? It doesn't know how to go to the other side. So, some souls come to take you. So if you have seen death, now if you have parents who have lived a longer life or people who have lived, they usually start getting dreams before they die of their old friends, old memories, they are coming my dreams, they are there. So actually these souls come down and they wait for you. But when you pass away, they help you. But these souls also cannot remain here indefinitely. They can stay for 72 hours. if you look back into our customs, we have a thing which we call chota. What is chota? A person dies, what do you do? Normally you take a photograph of the person who is custodian and you talk good about him, that he was a good person. And then you have a gathering where everybody comes and says, "We will do this." So soul is coming around, he realizes, okay, I've done something good over him, so I can do it. Nowadays what is happening? The program is between 4 and 5, the gathering, people come at 4 to 5. They come, show their face, and they're on the mobiles. Talking, "Achha woh mar gaya, he was talking as a lot." Now the soul is hearing everything. And because he is hearing everything, he will say, "I will not go." He will stay there. And those people will, other souls are coming to him. Similarly, a young person dies in an accident. He's got small children. He will not go. You know what happened to my children? Now these souls, they are what we call the earthworms. Earthworms. Okay. They are what we call these earthworms. Now the earthworms is a very harmless sounding word. If you want to be a little bit more scared, you can call them Matakti Atma. Okay. So whatever. Nothing to be scared of, it is just they are energies. Now these energies cannot survive just like that. So they usually go and attach to somebody else to live. So these living people who are there, normally you have a body, a mind and a soul. So now this comes and attaches to you. Now there is one body, one mind with two souls. So now the twist happens. Suppose the person who died in an accident was a young person who is used to drink every day. And he is roaming around, he goes and sees a person in a party who is having his, enjoying his drink. Once in a party, he is a party drinker, once in a while he drinks. So this one says, okay, this person is drinking, so I will be happy here because I drink this. Now this person from the party goes home, next in the evening, the other soul wants to drink. He says, "No, no, I don't drink." "Okay, let me drink. I'm feeling like drinking, so let me drink." He takes out a bottle and drinks. Goes to sleep. The next day again, evening, he again feels like drinking. He says, "No, no, I can't drink. I will become drunkard." So he doesn't drink. And the whole night he cannot sleep. The other soul will not let him sleep. He has a bad night. Following night, he remembers that troubled night, he again drinks, sleeps. So from an occasional drinker, he becomes a modern drinker. Very common. Many of my clients, this was worse. How we come to know? That person used to like Johnny Walker. The other soul used to like a Shiva speaker. And now from drinking Johnny Walker, he starts drinking. It's very funny, but that's, this is what happens. Many of these pains, suddenly you are having a pain in your home. There is no reason, you have done all the tests, everything is there. Everything comes back. But you are having a pain. You are having a pain. It is usually a soul, who is an older person who has died and has got arthritis or an injury to the leg. Pain of that soul is getting manifested. The moment you remove the other soul, the pain disappears. So it's almost like a magic. You have been suffering from that pain for 10 years and after 2 sessions you become painless. So when these things happen, you see the twists. So this is about the earth.